second reason why price or technical analysis is very important is because prices essentially move in trends. Prices move in trends, which means that if prices are moving lower, you will see that prices tend to move lower for a consistent period of time. In the same way that if prices are moving higher, prices tend to move persistently for a period of time. If you look at the stock market, whether you look at the index, an individual stock, cryptocurrencies, you can easily identify if prices are in an uptrend or in a downtrend or in a sideways trend. So prices essentially move in trends. And at least where we want to focus our capital is we want to focus inside uptrending issues. Do we have a bad market today? Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes. But inside a bad market, can you still find uptrending issues? Yes, of course, right? And lastly, history repeats itself. The reason why technical analysis is very effective is because not only does it lead the actual news, the actual fundamentals that come out, not only does it move in trends, where you can use technical analysis to identify trends and participate in the trends where you can have your money work for you, but you can also use technical analysis to understand that markets move in cycles. If you look at what's happening with certain stocks, whether it's a property company, a financial company, you'll see that all listed stocks pretty much follow a certain template. So they follow a certain cycle, a cycle where prices move up in a bull market, and then for a period, prices move down in a bear market. And then after some time again, prices move up in a bull market, and then after another, and then after that, it goes down in a bear market, and so on and so forth. So if you look at the financial markets, we've had 13 to 15 cycles since the Great Depression in 1929. I'm not just talking about the Philippines, I'm talking about the U.S. stock market as well. 13 to 15 cycles where you have a bull market and then you have a bear market. Completes one cycle and then you have another bull market and then you have another bear market. Bull market, bear market, right? So prices pretty much move in cycles, and if you can use technical analysis to understand cycles, then you can help that with your decision making and decide when are you going to be aggressive, when are you going to be defensive when it comes to your portfolio. So when we look at technical analysis, this is essentially the basic building block of technical analysis, which here it says candlestick charts. If you look at the basic component of every chart, the basic building block of every chart, it's a candlestick. A candlestick has four data points, as you'll see in your charting software. The four data points are open, high, low, and the close. If it's a white, or as in the charting software later, if it's a white or a green candle, did prices go up or down for the day? If prices are black and red, did it go up or down for the day? Down. So any favorite stock? S&PH. All right, very timely, S&PH. So what happened to S&PH today? Did prices go up or down? Prices went down for today. So when you look at the candlestick, there are two parts. There's the body and the tail. So the body is color red, which means that prices went down for the day, which means that the price as of now is lower than the open. But if you look at the tail, there's a tail on top. What does the tail represent? What does the tail represent? You see the tail over there? So the tail represents that during the day, maybe earlier this morning or later this morning, prices were trading at that high before moving lower for the day. So anybody know what happened to SM Prime? Why it's up that big? the past few days? Anyone? Yes. Very good. Increased weighting in MSCI. So every quarter, MSCI comes out with a rebalancing. So the importance of the MSCI is that the MSCI is essentially a benchmark or a model portfolio that a lot of the passive foreign funds follow. So usually when they come out with a change in their model portfolio, what do the subscribers of the portfolio need to do? Siyempre, kailangan nilang gayahin, di ba? Kasi model portfolio, they're subscribed to that portfolio, di ba? Especially if you look at the Philippine stock market. For the past 10 years, Philippine stock market has been 50% local, 50% foreign. Value traded. Which means that half of the participation in the Philippine stock market has been by foreign. And if you look at a certain demographic of that foreign participation are passive funds. Majority of those passive funds follow the MSCI benchmark, or what is also known as the MSCI, right? And the MSCI comes out with rebalancings every quarter, and it comes out with additions and deletions to its benchmark indices. They have a global standard index, which is the big cap. They essentially have a big cap and a small cap index, to put it simply. And for the big cap index, which is a huge fund, they increased the weighting of SM Prime by, I think, 1%? 1% thereabouts. So they increased the weighting by 55. And the deadline for foreign funds to copy the changes in the model, the deadline is May 31. So you see from the announcement, I think the announcement was somewhere here or here. Prices popped up, and then we'll see if prices continue to get some more foreign fund inflow until May 31. The announcement came in Tuesday morning for this. Thursday, Wednesday, Tuesday. You see that big candle Tuesday? What happened here? What happened here? Prices broke out. I introduced a term earlier today. I used the word breakdown. Breakdown is a beginning of a downtrend. Now what's the opposite? Opposite is called a breakout. A breakout is a beginning of an uptrend. Now, do prices move ahead of actual news? Yes, we can see it here. The announcement came here. But what happened 1, 2, 3, 4 days prior? Were prices already moving up? Yes. What does this tell you? What does, and tell me, prices were moving up, not just any move up, but it was moving up on twice the average volume. What does this tell you? Tells you that even before the announcement came out, people in the know, maybe we're already telling their friends, telling their family na bumili na kayo nito because it's going to be included in the MSCI index, right? Which is precisely why prices will always be a leading indicator, right? So you can see prices already moved up 4 days before the announcement. Which tells you that even before the announcement, it was already telling you, price was already communicating to you that something was already happening. When prices broke out, and here's the beauty with technical analysis. When you're doing technical analysis, you don't need to know the information. In this case, the MSCI information. All you need to know is that the people who know the information are already buying. And that is reflected in the chart in higher volume in the form of prices moving higher. And if it's significant information enough, then prices are breaking out. And in this case, as we see, starting to move higher, right? So as you'll see later, all of the charts that we'll be looking at use these candlesticks as basic building blocks. When you open your COL charting, as I've shown you a while ago, the basic default chart that comes up is essentially the daily chart, which means that one candlestick equals one day. But you can actually change that up. If you choose 1D, that's one day. Obviously, 1W equals 1 week. So let's try that, 1W, 1 week. So it shows you the candlestick, which represents 1 week. Why do we need all these configurations? As you learn later, some people might prefer to deal with longer term trends. Some people might prefer to deal with shorter term trends. We have a lot of traders that trade using 3-minute charts, 5-minute charts, 1-hour chart. We have a lot of long-term investors. I have a one of my teammates who has a client in the billions of pesos, who actually just look at long-term charts and they just stay with long-term trends, right? There are a lot of retail people who just use intraday charting. When you're starting out, I would recommend that you start out with the longer term trends, if this is something that you would like to try.